Welcome back to Hashtag, where we discuss the latest trends happening on social media. So if you love of social media, if you've been paying your OTT tax, and of course, if you've been using VPN, no problem, as long as you love social media. Now, Simbi, we've been discussing about the Nyege Nyege before we went to break, and you were crying to me how expensive it is, and I'm like, geez.
It's expensive, but another thing that is going to make me not to go there never, as you said, that this thing is having some, is it the LGBT what stuff?
Sure thing.
That gay stuff, like they were talking about. That's why it went so viral and trending on number one.
Sure thing.
We saw tweets with Father Lokodo that this is a sex event. It won't happen.
Do you support that?
Actually, things have perspectives.
Because I believe you, since you have never gone to Nyege Nyege, you might be on Lokodo's side. I can see it in your eyes, bro.
But you have to do this. Father Lokodo has to prove to us. You see? Father Lokodo has to prove to us that he has ever attended Nyege Nyege, so he knows what happens there.
Okay, let me talk to Karen. Karen, yeah. You've been in Kampala for a while now. Have you gone to Nyege Nyege before? A couple of editions have been.
I have not been to Nyege Nyege before, and this is the first time I'm hearing about Nyege Nyege.
Oh my God.
But it does sound like a really fun event, though. I mean, obviously, all these other things will happen at every event. So I think it's also a good thing. There's loads of artists coming. So
would you love to have the experience?
I'm not so sure. I don't know.
Okay, let me talk to Arthur, because Arthur's been excited. I think he's boiling up. He has so much knowledge when it comes to this. Have you been there for the last edition?
Yeah, I've been to Nyege Nyege, actually marketing it for the last, I don't know how many years. But the perspective changed this time around, I must say. Father Lokodo had a point. You get? Okay, I've been to Nyege Nyege, and what Father Lokodo said is a fact. There's open sex, there's taking drugs, there's alcohol, there's what, but this is normal stuff that we always see. Apart from one of the aspects that he pointed out of homosexuality and LGBTQI, you get, those are the ones that made people say, what the hell? So Nyege Nyege is all about this, but that's not all about Nyege
Nyege.
I have
a feeling maybe it was the whole entire thing of Lokodo coming out, and then the Prime Minister comes out and says it's a go on. Wasn't it a stunt to maybe boost?
Those guys actually, MTN got free PR. Last year, Bell was the main sponsor, and then this year, MTN took over. And these guys are going to make a lot of profits. Okay, they've always made a lot of profits. But on the tourism part, this is something good. What happens at Nyege Nyege is endless fun. You get? It's fun to whoever thinks it's fun, because you book either a hotel or, you know, you can use a tent. You sleep outside. And then there's performances from artists from literally the whole day. It's non-stop.
Non-stop. All day, all night.
Exactly. For 3 days. For 3 days. So that's why Father Lokodo was saying it's going to be, it comes with a lot of noise. They were given some precautions if it's going to continue, even for the next years, that police is going to be loitering around, you know,
so
that
police
people don't have
smoking,
open sex,
open
no
sex
smoking, ganja, no what, you know, a lot of precautions. Sex, if you're going to have sex, let it be private, not open. If it's going to be...
Let's clarify a bit of that. Yes. Are you serious that people at Nyege Nyege have open sex in public places?
But, first wait, if a tent is there and guys are here performing, aren't you hearing the noise?
But there is a lot of sound happening.
If you know what happens when a person is having sex, do you think the other people won't know that there's sex going on?
No, maybe because there's certain things in life that, you know, create a lot of attention. And even if the speakers are booming, still the small noise here, your ears will be down here.
Exactly, that's open sex. And if you've looked at the pictures for the past 2 years, people be naked.
Okay.
You get? But that's also part of fun. Because sometimes these bazungu like dancing in the rain, moving clothes. These are things they never do in their country.
Having the naked mile.
Yeah,
like
they don't have this
naked
temperature.
Yeah.
You get?
All right, you know,
exercising.
It's a big topic when you start talking about Nyege Nyege. But of course, shout out to everybody who's been who's attending right now. And I hope everything goes on well down there in Jinja. All right, let's talk about Something else, of course, when we talk about trends, Bobby Wine has been in the news, has been on social media for the last I don't know how many months, from OTT tax to Arua, and now finally he's abroad. Now, there's something I heard on social media that he's abroad, and he said he was going to come up with a conference, and he looked so amazingly that he's not even sick at all. How true is that?
Apparently, that's so true. Mm. Yeah, because everyone's talking about it everywhere. So we're actually all waiting for it. We're waiting to see what happens.
So in other words, Bobby Wine doesn't look sick at all?
No, sure. He doesn't. No.
Simi, tell me.
Yeah, you can be sick, yes, right?
Yes.
Everyone falls sick. So we know how a sick person behaves. Mm. So I heard Arthur saying that this guy is giving press conferences and stuff. What we have to say that maybe this guy got the medication he needed. Now he's okay.
There.
Yeah, from
is
there.
Okay?
Yeah, because Zaka is nowhere to be seen.
Does that mean that you don't have that medication in Uganda?
The medication is here, but the thing is different. There is more of mudslinging. We don't understand what's happening.
The outside world, and, you know?
No, it's like I heard that these guys were promised free medication. Is it true?
When you read through Babi Chagulanyi's Facebook post, if you go back right now and you read through how the man was tortured, how his balls were squeezed according to his recent post, how his kidneys were shattered, how he has an injury here, how the skull got injuries, and you look at Bobby Wine right now, you just say, in Chris Variomonsi's words, the guy was just politicking. The guy just wanted to leave the country.
If you were Bobby Wine, yeah, wouldn't you want to, at least after this Aruba thing, at least to go abroad and have some fresh air?
Exactly. Yeah. That's the only thing I can say, that the man just wanted to leave the country and then go abroad. Maybe
imagine we're having a lot of smoke in
exactly,
this room right now.
And you know, breathe.
Yeah.
Because really, when you look at the guy, you know, I'm sure you've been at a press conference. Cameras are here, lights are here, just that alone can give you a headache. He's supposed to be on cannulas, intensive care, things like that. But right now, the guy is addressing the press, he's very serious, emphasizing points. Seriously,
amazing.
That's not
when is he coming back to Uganda?
A sick person does. No, I'm not sure, but I've seen some complaints between him, his lawyers, and the Ugandan government that, you know, it stresses him very much, and it's a very bad environment for him. So,
maybe the guy may go
and do cheyo. That's why you never know.
All right, let's talk about Honorable Amelia Chambadeb, since we're talking about things happening abroad. What happened to Honorable Amelia Chambadeb? I saw it trending on social media too.
I heard that she's embezzling funds, and there is like a video that flows, and she was abroad, right?
Yeah.
She started speaking in Luganda like Mulozanzi ndimobi nalinzibya kusente. Stuff of that type. You get. So I think this Ugandan government has many big people who are rich, but these guys, there's not any Ugandan who has never embezzled funds who is in the government.
I just wish we had so much time, because when these guys start talking, man, you would want to listen and, you know, it gets over and over again. All right, let's talk about the nudes. Like I promised, we have something that's been trending concerning the nudes. Karen, I want to ask you one question. Mm-hmm. You get?
Yeah.
Do you think taking nude pictures is a trend these days that anybody should try out, or every woman should try out?
I think nudes has always been a trend to kind of get public attention.
Has always been a trend.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Meaning that, Karen, anytime we can expect anything from you.
I mean, not me. Not me. That's not my style. But it's
style, maybe.
No.
Okay.
But yeah, that's the thing. People just use that for attention, and that's it. Nothing
okay.
more to it.
Just
yeah.
in a few seconds, tell me, what do you think about the nudes before Arthur can give us entire recap of what happened this week when it comes to nude pictures?
Yeah.
You think it's a trend?
To women in Uganda, most women in Uganda, because you'll be on your WhatsApp, you give someone your number, and the next day you find someone scrolling nudes in your DM.
Sure thing.
Yeah.
All right, Arthur.
Yeah.
What happened this week when it comes to sharing nude pictures?
Yeah.
Because we always have these stories in just a minute.
This week we had a Uganda version of, you know, the West, where Diana Chinobe, I don't know, there were allegations that her Instagram page was hacked, but there were nudes boobs and stuff. Some people,
but if they hack your Instagram, does it mean they've hacked the entire phone?
The whole thing of hacking, I'm still wondering, because if they hack into your account, why would they again post your own nudes?
Yeah,
like we saw recently when Zari's Instagram was hacked, things were deleted. Mm-hmm. Other nudes of people, Chinese, were tweeted, but her own. Someone came on Twitter, he's called Paul Webbs, he calls himself Mr. Hashtag. He came and then tweeted the nudes and then said, you know what, this girl is the same girl who was telling us that OTT is okay, it's a very small amount, and then now we are seeing she's posting nudes. Kind of is this, in his words?
Anyway, I know we don't have enough time, but I just want to thank you so much, Arthur, Karen, Simbi. It's been amazing hanging out with you guys, because it's my first time to be on the show. And I feel like I think I should take over the show. Willis, I just wish you could stay in the hospital for a couple of weeks so that we can have some good time with my people right here. Remember, it's Hashtag here on Urban TV. And of course, my name is MC Casmel. You can get me on Twitter, Casmel UG. Arthur, how can I get you?
Digital Didan.
Digital Didan.
We are official
and
256 Nsimbi at 256. Don't forget. Don't touch.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. Thank you, David on the camera and the entire crew. Billy, God bless you and bless us too.